saw who would listen to his ma when she told him he should go to school. And he'd sneak away in the afternoon to a little walk, then pretty soon you'd find him at the local auction bar. Well, he'd stand and listen carefully until at last he began to see how the auctioneer could talk so rapidly. Well, he said, oh my, it's do or die, I've got to learn that auction cry, gonna make my mark and be an auctioneer. $25 bid, and now $30, 30, will you make a 30 bid? I want a $30, 30, will you give me 30, will you give me $30 bill? I got a $30 bid, and now $35, will you make a 35, will you 35, give me 35, who's gonna bid another $35 bill? But now time went by and he did his best, and all could see he did not jest. He practiced calling bills both the night and day. Yeah, his pappy would find him behind the barn, just a working up an awful storm. He tried to imitate the auctioneer. Well, his pappy said, son, we just can't stand to have a mediocre man selling things at auction using our good name. Well, I'm gonna send you all to auction school, and then you'll be nobody's fool, and you can take your place among the best. $35 bid, and now $40, 40, will you make a 40 bid? I want a $40, 40, will you give me 40, hey, give me $40 bill? I got a $40 bid, and now 45, will you make a 45, who's a 45, give me 45, who's gonna bid another $45 bill? And now from the boy who went to school, there grew a man who played it cool. He'd come back home a full-fledged auctioneer. His people would come from miles around just to hear him make that rhythmic sound that filled their hearts with such a happy cheer. Well, his fame spread out from shore to shore. He'd all that he can do and more. He had to buy a plane to get around. Well, now he's the best in all the land. Let's pause and give that man a hand, 'cause he's the best of all the auctions.